Combatants literally kicked the heck out of each other. Believe it or not, the states of New Jersey and Nevada, among others, actually license these kinds of displays, and they are televised all over the world. So the question is, should ultimate fighting be banned throughout the United States?
The Ultimate Fighting Championship is gaining momentum. The league known as the UFC has become North America's fastest rising sport amongst adults ranging from 18 to 40.
But is the sport too violent?
What I usually think about is kick them in the face with my shin. I start grinning, man.
It isn't like a lot of other sports because you realize that somebody could get hurt in there, and it does, as I say, it does appear violent. The glove.
Physical violence from me onto my opponent is funny to me. I guess it's like an extreme version of Charlie Chaplin comedy, you know?
The gloves that they have on have barely any padding.
Everybody has a plan until they get punched.
And they are striking to the head and they are kicking.
Got a good shin kick right to his neck, went down on the ground, I was punching, I was looking at the ref screaming, you better stop the fight, you better stop the fight, but didn't stop the fight.
The fact that you do get bleeding and you do get a lot of hand-to-hand combat.
Do you think that this sport is too violent?
They're back in the old days of the UFC, which is when it started. You didn't have a lot of people who were trained in a lot of things. It was just tough guys who wanted to beat each other's brains in. Now they're all guys who have been trained in martial arts so they can defend themselves even when they get in trouble. So you don't get a lot of guys, as I say, who seriously get hurt because they actually know how to take care of themselves when they're in there.
I mean, this is where we all train. This is where all the fighters train, man. This is where, you know, myself, Ben Saunders, who's, you know, Ultimate Fighter veteran, Tom Mahler, Steve Ramos, all the up-and-coming fighters are here. All the veteran fighters are here. This is the place to train in Orlando for sure.
Why is it worth it to you to do it?
It's tough when you're like, we have guys in here to go to school, work, and then they have to train. You know, now if you're going up against a guy who's down the street training, you know, he doesn't go to work, he doesn't go to school, and all he's doing is training and fighting. So I think the toughest decision guys have to make now is whether this is they try to pursue this as a career.
Why am I doing this? Why am I here? Is this worth it? Such a mix of emotions. Feels like you want to like vomit, cry, celebrate, just do everything at once.
Oh my gosh, I'm sorry, but I'm watching this and it's just about making my stomach sick looking at I'm serious.
And then we all go through the same type of training, you know. We're all in the same boat, man. We're all nervous, but if someone says they're not nervous, they're lying to you. Everyone's a little bit nervous about something.
Push! Good one, mate.
You got all types coming here. You got pretty boys in here. You got people that are like, you know, all they want to do in life is fight. They grew up on the streets. They've been fighting their whole lives, so they just want to get in the ring. You've got people that have been in athletics their whole life, college-educated people that, you know, wrestle in college. So you just got all walks of life in the sport, which I think is pretty cool. Ralph is phenomenal. He's a great wrestler. Stand-up's actually decent too. He came into it to our gym about a half a year ago or so with some other fighters. Great guy. I'm kind of ticked off that he's not fighting for our team, for the Iron Monkeys, but whatever. He's going to fight for Dean's team. I think he'll do good. He's going to win his fight, definitely.
With straight shots and then pop bottles. Flirt with the hood rats, then pop models. Talk with straight shots and then pop bottles. Flirt with the hood rats, then pop models. Talk with straight shots and then pop bottles. Flirt with the hood rats, then pop models. Talk with straight shots and then pop bottles. Flirt with the hood rats, then pop models.
The Terrors and the Devils will compete in five matches, followed by a second match of five fights between your hometown Lakeland Blaze and the Cincinnati Norsemen.
He came in, was actually teaching wrestling everybody, and you know, I mean, he takes me down, he just takes everybody down in here. So he has, you know, all the best tools. But because he's a good athlete, you know, he started working on his jiu-jitsu and his striking, and I mean, his future at the weight class, I mean, he could be really, really good. The thing about Acosta is he's tough. He's a little mean, but he's exciting, you know? Like, you know, he'll get a guy, he'll have a guy's back, instead of trying to choke him, he'll pick him up and slam him again before he chokes him.
I've always been a small guy, ever since I was little, coming up. Always had to play with the big boys, get used to it. You know, and they lock that cage behind you, it's very surreal. You're in a cage with another person, only one winner is coming out.
Ralph is a winner, you know. He just lost tonight, but Ralph is a true winner. He's a true champion. You know, one thing we're going to do with Ralph is we're probably going to move him down to 135. But you know, Ralph just needs to train. You know, that's all. You know, he's going to train even harder and come back stronger. And I see Ralph being a champion one day.
I don't know, man. I just want to make it that next level, man. I want to make this my job. You know, full time, all day, all night. That'd be awesome for me. Because I know everybody. I mean, this is gonna end eventually, you know. My body's not gonna be able to keep up with it. So, you know, if I can get as much done and win as much, accomplish all that I want to accomplish, or at least half of it, it'd be good, you know. I'd say it's a job well done. And I could move on to the next portion of my life.